Well, I think when I first became involved in this field, quite a while ago, 40 years ago, it was seen as kind of an exotic kind of a syndrome. And the frequency of the incidence data suggests it was 4 in 10,000. And it turns out that the frequency of the incidence of this syndrome is a lot more frequent. It's a lot higher than 4 in 10,000. It's more like 1 in 100, 1 in 90 perhaps. I think early on, I think it was also kind of a puzzle because it seemed like people who were diagnosed with autism would have a variety of different kinds of characteristics. Some of the characteristics were, some people had all the characteristics, all the classic characteristics. Some of the people had maybe only one or two of them. And I think early on we recognized that it was probably more of a continuum. And I think that kind of approach has been borne out because it's seen as a spectrum. It's autism spectrum disorder. That makes it difficult to understand or difficult to make sense of sometimes. As far as a cure, there is no cure for it. However, some of the characteristics can be treated quite effectively. The treatment that has been shown scientifically to be an effective treatment modality is applied behavior analysis. Applied behavior analysis involves an objective way of looking at behavior, objective measurement, looking at methodologies that involve changing the environment, manipulating things in the environment, and looking at the effects of those treatments on the measurements that we have that are objective. As far as being misunderstood, I think the biggest issue for being misunderstood is, number one, it's a spectrum disorder, so there's a lot of variability in the diagnosis. And number two, there's no cure. That makes it a puzzle. Someday there'll be a cure, we hope. And hopefully that someday will come sooner rather than later. I think, there is hope. There's two things that when we work with families that we really try and emphasize. Number one is early intervention. It's a lot easier to intervene with these kids when they're 2 or 3 or 4 years old than if they're 18 or 19. Early intervention is key. Number two, we think that applied behavior analysis offers the best hope for parents. And applied behavior analysis, again, is just a way, it's a methodology for having objective measurement so we can tell if there's treatment gains being realized. And then number two, breaking things down into small steps and teaching those sub-skills and small skills, putting all the skills together into a kind of a functional unit for each kid. We focus a lot on language, and given that there's critical periods of language development, the first 6 years is critical. That's why early intervention is really, really important. And having a teaching model, we're teaching kids important skills to kind of jumpstart their development and progress.